You better get down there before she makes the situation impossible. I'll tend to the DeLorean.
I mean, we could do it again from the pool.
Nah. So, basically what happened was, he said that he needed to
age
replace...
to perfection.
Well, we basically aged that thing twice.
Because we didn't...
Pause. Yeah, we can. We basically aged the...
Well, we realised we didn't do... We did it one few times.
It aged 7 hours and it needed to age 12 hours to destroy the suit.
So we basically did another 8 hours.
Yeah, well, we did. We put it back in, did another 8 hours, and Doc says that the problem with the time machine is that he needs to replace some sort of circuits with titanium.
But
titanium won't be commercially available until 9 years' time, so...
We also saw that Edna, who he was talking to, has wandered off to the lab.
Yes, so...
Surprised Marty didn't spot that.
Yeah.
Anyway. So. Sorry about that. We just had a bit of a mix-up with the recording.
Blame Doctor Who.
Yeah, which was terrible, by the way.
Yeah.
Hey, Emmett, I'm back.
Too late.
Player. I mean,
Oh, my.
You know, I thought you were coming down here to keep Emmett focused on his invention.
Oh, she is. But she's generously scheduled brief canoodling breaks every 45 minutes to keep my mind fresh.
Time's up, dear. Let's get back to work.
Shall we?
Not every couple gets canoodling.
Now, Mr. Callahan, what can I do for you?
Oh, God, we have to get pasta.
I left something in the lab. I need to talk to him.
Can I go into the lab for a bit? I think I left something in there.
Sorry, but I'm afraid the lab is off-limits until Emmett's finished tuning the mental alignment meter.
But...
No exceptions.
I need to talk to Emmett.
Can I talk to Emmett? It's kind of important.
It'll have to wait until later. Emmett's got a lot to do before the expo opens.
Isn't yeah, a lot
that
more
right, darling?
You know it, Schnookums.
Oh,
Schnookums?
Yeah. You can talk to him later.
Yeah, Carl Sagan.
Mr. Sagan says he needs to talk to you back at the high school.
He does. Whatever for?
Your invention.
Don't just say them out loud. Just tell me which one, Edward. People can read.
One on the bottom.
He says he's got a lead on the speakeasy arsonist.
He does he? Well, I'm not sure anyone cares about that old story anymore. But I suppose I could spare a few minutes in the service of solving a crime. Will you be all right without me, sweetheart?
It'll be tough, but I think I'll muddle through.
Try to keep him focused. He's so easily distracted.
Don't I wish.
There we go. Right, so we're here again.
I remember that picture from Edna's apartment in 1986. It's a kid and a relative of Edna, so it's probably a positive figure.
Negative, go on.
Emmett's invention makes him out to be a model citizen, huh? Well,
Marty, we know what we're doing.
Yeah, once we were blind, but now we see.
I don't understand how Emmett cannot notice us doing all this.
He's very easily distracted by his invention. So that's instantly controlled, done. And then this final one, Chewie.
Oh my. I know this is supposed to be a positive response, but...
Well, for us in this puzzle...
Oh god!
Bad smell! Oh, but...
How do I... I can't skip it! Oh, no.
It's just gonna keep changing between both of them forever. Oh no, it's Trixie.
I told you it's Trixie.
Yeah, it's hard to tell.
Trixie. I don't think Edna approves of her, so I guess she's a negative figure.
Right, it's a yellow at the moment, so we need positive smell. The smell.
Oh yeah. How did it go great? Oh yeah, because we need to sort it back. They say I'm crazy, got no
sense, but I don't care. And that's it. Good job, Harry.
I did it.
We iced him.
I guess we did it, because now it's broken.
Hey, Emmett, I think your mind map test is broken.
Oh, that switch just keeps shorting out on me.
No time to
fix it now. I'll have to take care of it at the expo.
Looks like I'm not going to be doing any more mind maps. I guess I'll test this out and hope for the best.
Well, that's a good sign, because that means we don't have
maybe
to
maybe we've done it wrong and we never get to fix it.
Except the game's broken.
Yeah. Okay, what did we get? Degenerate criminal. Come on.
Yeah. Good job, Al.
Now Emmett's mind map is as bad as Tannen's. Now all I have to do is swap this out with Emmett's original mind map and Emmett's own machine will do him in.
Yeah, and that will also ruin their experiment as well.
Yeah, how did Emmett also not hear everything and see everything that I've been doing this past life?
Maybe he's still thinking about Trixie's song.
Oh, and Trixie. I mean,
Okay, Emmett, get ready to meet the new you.
Hey!
What? Pretty much the same.
I almost left behind my mind map.
Oh, thank you.
We're gonna show it off at the expo as a rare example of a model citizen. Edna, kill me if I forgot that.
She might kill you anyway when she gets a look at that mind map. Once Emmett gets to the expo, I'll try to figure out how to get him to put his card in the mental alignment meter.
Uh-huh.
But for now, I better concentrate on making Emmett a slob.
So, look at the hints briefly so we can remember what to do with this sort of thing. Its cleanser is now seething steel cloth destroying enzymes. Yeah, let's go find him. We need to, or his suit at least. So we need to go find him at the expo probably. Oh no, he's still here. I thought he'd gone off.
I guess spray this on him.
There it is. I've been looking all over for my portable anti-stick anti-stain formula. Where'd you find it?
Out by the trash.
That's strange. I haven't been out there for hours. Oh well.
Are you gonna spray your jacket? Busy. It's looking a little dusty.
Not until it's really dirty. This cleanser doesn't grow on trees, you know. Well, some of the ingredients grow on trees, but the rest are synthesized polycarbonate
really
detergent blends.
I can do that. I'll wait until you're at the expo to show Edna what a suit-destroying slob you can be.
Well, that's about it.
What is?
Yep. As soon as I get all this stuff loaded into the truck, I'll be ready for the expo.
He hasn't actually been doing anything to fix the machine.
How about I go tell Edna you're coming? I'll get her ready for you to pop the question.
Good thinking. Go on ahead. I'll meet you there.
I really hope this works.
Yeah, this is a high-risk strategy. If it somehow goes well, Edna randomly decides she likes me as well.
Marty!
Doc! What's all the activity? What time is it? Where is it?
Just tell me which one you want. Don't read them out, please.
Okay. It's hard to tell. Try middle one.
What time is it?
It's almost time for the opening ceremony.
Of the Olympics?
Holy jeez, I better work fast. I think I got it all worked out. When it all comes together, Edna will think you're the worst guy in town. I just need a couple more pieces.
Well, don't go to too much trouble.
What do you mean? Oh!
You fixed the DeLorean?
You got the time circuits fixed.
Not exactly. You see, I've been mulling things over, and...
Oh, God.
In the timeline you're from...
The right timeline?
Yeah.
Yes. I've got a wife.
A great wife, Clara, and kids, and a dog, and a bitchin' time train.
Bitchin'? How does her story turn out? How does she end up?
Of course.
Oh, well, Edna ends up...
Tell the truth, Marty. Alone and miserable.
What, do we know the truth?
Yeah, we do. Remember, she's like crazy pensioner in a flat with her cats. Alone and miserable, happy and fulfilled. It's best not to know.
I don't think we want to straight up lie, so...
You're not really supposed to know these things in advance. It's bad luck.
But you told me how my story turns out.
Yeah,
but...
And it's not as if I'll be in a position to do anything about it once my younger counterpart's destiny has shifted. I imagine I'll be folded into the new timeline, and I'll probably lose all memory of the old one.
Maybe.
So tell me, this just to satisfy my curiosity, what's going to become of Edna?
I don't know, what do you
try happy and fulfilled, see if he falls for it.
No, I think we want to tell him the truth. I don't want to lie. I'm going to tell him
the truth. No, let's see what happens
when
he lies.
This could affect the ending, though. Think about it.
No, it won't. Look, we all know that we're supposed to say hello to misery. We'll see what happens if you lie.
Just because I want to say hello to misery.
We'll have to tell the truth eventually.
I want to say hello to misery.
You want to hurt him?
Yeah, let's hurt him!
To be honest, she ends up kind of sad.
Sad?
She lives with some cats in a dinky little apartment, and she spends most of her time yelling out her window at people, and collecting newspapers, and living in the past.
I see. Perhaps we've been going about this problem the wrong way. Do we really have to completely obliterate my timeline so we can restore yours?
Who knows? Moral quandary.
Maybe we could have the best of both worlds. I could be with Edna, but it could be a little bit, you know, more healthy.
Can you hear yourself? Do you know what you're saying? Let me remind you.
What about Clara?
She turned Hill Valley into a police state. She turned you into a puppet. She tried to erase your brain.
She turned you into a puppet.
Yeah.
She took over your life. She kept you from doing what you were meant to do till there was nothing left of you but this hollow shell.
Maybe. But she only did it because she cared.
I don't believe this!
All I'm saying is, let's stop and take a breath. This elaborate plan to derail my younger self's love life, is the short-term misery worth the long-term gain? Maybe we can find a third way. One where everybody wins. What do you think?
Not okay, no, I can't. Well, that's not a lot of choice there, is that? Doesn't look like a lot of conflict going on here with Marty.
No! I'm sorry, Doc. I can't go along with what you're saying. You don't belong with Edna.
So you're determined to break us up, in spite of my stated wishes?
Basically, yeah.
Then there's nothing left to say.
Come on. Wait, where are you going?
Why should it matter to you? Aren't you planning on overriding me?
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, but if he's gonna override it, oh no, he's not gonna mess around with the time.
Is it fixed?
No, he said not exactly. Well, he might have been lying.
Hmm.
No. God, well, that made me feel really bad about everything we've just spent ages trying to figure out how to do.
Yeah.
Ooh, he looks like Emmett's in a bit of a pickle.
I like pickles. Pickle goes really well with
cheese. Hey, Andrew, what's keeping you?
You took his hat off.
Oh, hello, Harry.
Hello.
I guess I've got a mild case of stage fright. I'm about to play my big scene, you know? No telling how Edna's gonna react. Wish me luck. Oh, for Pete's sake.
He's got the oil on,
isn't he? God, can you do it? In the same spot as
you've well. Got something on your suit,
but the enzymes would have eaten it through ages ago, wouldn't they?
Oh
no, wait, he hasn't.
It's only been a couple hours.
Anti-stain formula, work your magic.
Emmett,
just in the nick of time. Step back now, we're gonna need a little space here.
Oh, aren't you a vision, like something that descended from the heavens?
Yes, I'm feeling a bit elevated at the moment. There's something I've just gotta ask
Wait,
you.
Wait, your tie's a bit crooked.
I've been holding it inside for weeks now, and I've simply gotta get it off my chest!
Oh.
Uh-oh.
My grandfather's suit!
My formula!
Oh.
Look! Turn your head! I'll be right back, and we can try this all over
and
again!
And it's Lathrop Brown!
Huh?
Trixie Trotter? How do you know this woman?
I don't! I mean, I listened to some of her records, and I may have taken a picture of her, but I...
Go on! Deny to the world that you know me! Perhaps it is true, but I know you all too well.
What is going
she
on
like
here?
You rich boys are all alike. You think material possessions can compensate for a broken heart. Well, you can take back your furs!
Oh,
and take
it.
Back this gaudy diamond,
Ouch.
Too!
Oh,
I don't need your expensive presents. I need you. And more importantly, little Emmett Jr.
Whoa!
Well...